Hey there, this is a quick video to show you how to download your ConferZoom recorded classroom sessions, upload those to 3C Media Solutions, submit them for closed captioning, and then securely embed them into Canvas. Let's get started. First, go to conferzoom.org and log in with your credentials. Once you successfully log in, you'll land on this page. All your recordings will be in this left-hand side. Click the Recordings tab, and you'll see all the recordings you have available to you. Now, Zoom records several things when you're recording your classroom session. Look at this one, it has 6 files. If I click on that, it has several recordings because I had started and stopped the recording a couple of times. It has a shared screen with speaker view. That's the one you're gonna wanna download. It has an audio only, and it has an audio transcript if that's enabled. I'm gonna go back to recordings. I'll click on my orientation meeting. And in this case, I have an audio transcript, I have an audio only, and I have my classroom recording, the video recording, the speaker view. I can download all 3 with this button, or I can just click the download arrow here to download just the one I want. I'll click that download one, and I'll select the download video MP4. Now once you download, you'll see in the lower left-hand corner that it's downloading to my computer right now. That's going straight to my downloads folder. Whether you're on a Mac or a PC, the default is for it to go to your downloads folder. I'll click Finder, because that's where my computer saves. It's like the files area for a Mac. You'll click on Files, and click Downloads, and here's your file. It's my MP4. Once you have that down, you can rename it if you want for ease of use of identifying it later. Biology 100 Monday 5/4/2020, for example, to make it easy to find. Next, you're going to go to 3C Media Solutions. And the web address is 3cmediasolutions.org. If you don't have a class yet, if you don't have an account yet, just click the Register tab and fill out this brief form. You'll immediately get into 3C Media Solutions, but you won't be able to upload your video until they've verified that your account is valid through San Diego Canyon College. Once you get that verification, which may take a couple of days, click the login link. Log in with your credentials, and you'll notice now you have a media tab. Once you have the media tab, you can click that and start uploading your media. Click the upload, add upload media button. Just click next to upload a video from 3C to 3C Media Solutions, or if you already have it on YouTube, you can just submit the YouTube link. That's really nice so they can close caption it for you even though you already have it on YouTube. Click next, give it a title, description if you want. The license is Creative Commons only, or if you select none, it's all rights reserved. So it's all your property. And then click to that you agree to their terms and click next. Click select file. Navigate to your downloads folder, select that course that you downloaded, and click open. All right, so once you click that, click the upload file button, and it will start to process. Now this can take a while, so you may want to just come back in a few hours and see if it's complete. They're gonna need to not only upload it, but they're gonna have to process it as well. So once you come back into 3C Media Solutions, click on your media link and locate that class that you've uploaded. You'll notice in my case, there's one that I've added and it's not available for me yet. Once it's available for you, then you can submit it for captioning. So for example, for this video right here, Once I click on it, you'll see that it's available. I can preview it in this window and scroll down, and I could submit this video for captioning. Click the captioning link. Give it a title. If that one's okay, you can leave it. And have this ready. Just make sure that you know how long the video is. Put the length in minutes, hours, minutes, seconds. And put your section number in. Select the appropriate term and click submit. Once you do that, it'll take about 3 to 5 business days for them to caption your media, and you will get a message here in your messages area and an email telling you that your file is ready and captioned. Once you get that email, come back into 3C Media Solutions, click Media, locate that video that you would like to embed into Canvas. It's the same spot that you went to submit it for captioning. This time, you're just going to scroll down to the bottom until you see the embed code link. Single click into there, and then you're going to want to copy this HTML coding. Don't worry, you won't need to do any programming. Just right click on the mouse and click copy, or you can do Command C on a Mac or Control C on a PC to copy, and then navigate over to Canvas. Okay, now I'm creating a page here in Canvas, but anywhere you see this rich text editor, you can embed a video. So this can be a page, a discussion, an assignment, a quiz, whatever it is. As long as you have these tools available to you, you can embed the video. So I'm going to click in here. I'm going to give myself an extra line, and I'm going to title it. Might want to give it a date. Now you can put one video on a page or multiple videos on a page. It just depends on how you want to deploy it. In this particular case, I'm going to show you how to do multiples. After you've titled one, then you go ahead and hover over the insert/edit media icon and click it. Select the embed tab and then paste in that code. You can right click and paste, or you can Command V or Control V to paste it, and click OK. Once you've done that, you'll see the thumbnail pop up, and it'll be ready for you to submit. Just one last thing, make sure that we're ADA accessible, and this is a heading, so just click anywhere in that line and designate it as a heading level. Now, if it's too big for you, that's okay. You can highlight that and make it whatever size you want. You can make it bold if you want, but notice that it's still identified as a heading level 2. That's important for our ADA expectations. And then click submit or save. You'll want to save and publish if you want to make it available to your students. I'm just clicking save right now to show you how it works. If you wanted to add another class, you'd probably want to add it on top. So you'll click edit. And that's why I saved a little bit of space at the top. I'm gonna add a couple more characters and another space, give myself a heading level 2, and I'm gonna say and if you want, you can take that size down. Oops, in this case, triple click and make it bold, or you can just leave it at the default. Now, wherever you want that video to pop up, just put your cursor in there, select the Insert Edit Media button, go get that embed code for the new video from 3C Media Solutions and paste that code in here. I'm going to paste the same code in here just to show you how it works, and it'll pop it right in. I'll click Save just to show you, and now I've got 2 videos. It's important to note that this video, once the student logs into Canvas, this is the only spot that they can access this video. It is not shareable. It can be made full screen, but the students don't get a link to share this video with other people outside of Canvas, so they must log in. So it's the most secure way you can put your classroom session into Canvas, and your closed captioning will be available. And that's it. If you guys have any questions, please don't hesitate to give me a call or an email. I'm happy to help, and I hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you online.